I'm a family medicine board certified physician, and I've chosen to specialize in urgent care medicine. We oftentimes will do procedures. It's acute care medicine, so laceration repair, broken bones, things of that nature. We do a lot of disease management, a lot of times more acute than chronic. Chronic being management of diabetes, high blood pressure, etc. And we're trained to do that, and oftentimes we will do that. But mainly it's what's bothering you now, what's bothering you today. Let's fix it. The thing that comes to mind would be fluid mechanics classes that I had, and what you learn about in these sort of classes is you learn about fluid flow, of course, you learn about pumps, you learn about the circulatory system, essentially. That is, your heart is a pump, your blood vessels are pipes, if you will, that allow for fluid flow. And so the classes that I would have in medical school, specifically geared towards, say, the cardiovascular system, it just made sense. I'd seen those diagrams before. They just didn't have a little heart drawn for it. You work very well with boundary conditions, whether they be mechanical, say for a car or a bridge, or boundary conditions in a human body, blood pressure, socioeconomic status, limitations to healthcare, etc. And it's that ability to juggle multivariable process and actually put them together for a cohesive whole that was just invaluable for me, is getting that ME background. There is no better place to actually get a solid set of problem-solving skills that you can apply to any field, not just medicine. If you look at the curriculum of mechanical engineering, it has subcategories within it. You've got your fluid dynamics, you've got your dynamic systems and control, kind of your machine elements type things. You can go all the way to your biomed offshoots, etc. And each of those requires a certain skill set, a certain way that your mind is bent and expanded. And because of that, you get exposed to a large array of different ways of thinking, even within mechanical engineering as a discipline. And so because of that, you're very well set up to go into business, medicine, finance. You've had that ability to just go in and solve the problems once again. Those are going to be the difference makers, the game changers, the people you want on your team to move forward to solve those as of yet unsolvable problems. I'm Nathan Rylander, and I'm a mechanical engineer.